Questions, we all have them. Why am I bleeding? Why does my body ache? What is puberty? Puberty is defined as a period of growth for both the mind and body. As young kids rapidly grow to become adults, more questions about this change naturally arise. Puberty is a topic that is shrouded in mystery in India, from boys magically becoming men to a young girl surviving although she bleeds for 5 to 7 days every month, or even the uncertainty surrounding sanitary products. When I was in 5th grade, I remember the teachers pulling the girls aside and touching upon the topic of puberty. But they never did this to the boys, nor did they get into detail or give us any advice. If this is the situation in schools where kids of a privileged background go to, how much worse is it for the underserved? They say curiosity kills the cat, but in this case, it just makes you a social outcast, which in India is a fate worse than death. All of these conversations are kept under tight wraps, which leads to generations of questions piling up on both sides. And if you add social prejudice to the mix, it becomes unclear whether the scale is balanced or not.
Hi, my name is Aditi Chawla, and my project, Project SOS, is about puberty.
Puberty is something that everyone goes through, but nobody talks about. Most parents in India usually disregard the importance of talking to their children about the changes that go through their body during this period. This leads to a lot of mental stress. My project aims to raise awareness about three things that I think are essential to know about: puberty, health and hygiene during puberty, and gender inequality due to puberty. I decided to divide my project into three parts dedicated to different age groups and their interests. The first part of my project is altered to fit the requirements of kids from the age group of 10 to 12. I decided to make worksheets with puzzles and mind games to help the kids understand better without facing opposition from the adults. The second part of my project is dedicated to adolescents from the age group of 13 to 18 who already have a base on which I can work on and give them further more detailed information. The third part of my project is a workshop tailored to those who are going through puberty, in which I can go into detail about how to take care of your body during puberty. As my project progressed, I learned how to communicate much better than when I started off, as the 1M1B program is designed to help you grow and make connections. In level 2, we were asked to take interviews, and despite having a rocky start, after taking more than 60 interviews, I can finally say that I'm much better than when I started. One of my most unexpected pivots was actually because of one of these interviews that I took with my grandma. During the interview, she describes her experience with bullying due to a stain on her skirt, and this interview convinced me that boys too had to be aware of this topic, as such incidents only happen due to the lack of awareness. When I brought this up in a group mentoring session, I was encouraged to include this, which in turn made me include gender equality too, and from that moment, the purpose of my project became much larger. During my project, I was met with multiple challenges, including opposition from the teachers, but the biggest one was the pandemic. As my project is based on interaction with the kids, the pandemic turned out to be a challenge that I simply couldn't work around. The NGO that I was initially working with decided they would stop supporting me, as they required all hands on deck for their other major projects related to the current crisis. This was a hard blow to recover from, but my mentors from 1M1B convinced me to start a fundraiser, through which I could collect money to provide the underprivileged population with sanitary products and essentials. Through this fundraiser, I have successfully raised 23,000 rupees, all of which I've spent towards relief. The fundraiser gave me the motivation that I needed to continue, and I started working on making my worksheets better with the help of Ecofem and doctors, and I even ended up taking a session at my house. Through my project, I learned not to give up, as there always is another way, another path, and the reason something didn't work out is because you just didn't find that path yet.
I would like to wrap this up by encouraging whoever's watching this to ask questions and answer questions, you know, the answer to. And without questions, there are no answers.